Hello students, welcome to back day 14. We will be learning lesson number 27. So second slide again it tells about spoken tutorial, assignment and test. Let us start lesson number 27, imperative sentences and causative verb. Imperative sentences means to order, advise, request or convey. There is verb first form plus object. For an example, if I take order, go. Go is verb first form. And if I want to add object, to go with Ram. Same as per if I take request, please and kindly verb first form plus object. Please kindly, please meet me in the garden area. Kindly meet me in the garden area. These type of sentences always taken the second person for the subject. Most of the time the subject remain hidden. For an example, bring me a glass of water. I am sitting here. Somebody else is sitting in front of me. I am telling him or her, bring me a glass of water. I am requesting to her to bring a glass of water. What is the function of imperative sentences? Usually, the job of imperative sentences is to give command or instruction. It tells us to do something. Look at this example. Help. Go now. Don't sit here. These are the examples of imperative sentences where we get to know whether the person is giving order, advice, request or convey or instructions. This is an example image of imperative sentences. Request. You are requesting somebody. Pack enough clothes for the cruise. Please pack my clothes. Invitation. You are inviting somebody at somewhere else. Come over at 8. Command. Sit down. Do not disturb me. This is a command. Instruction. Turn left at the intersection. These are the words or part of imperative sentences. How do we use an imperative sentences? That means where to use and how to use imperative sentences. Direct command. We can also give them an instruction or more politely than a straight command. Look at this positive and negative examples which is noted down. Example context is given positive and negative effect. Army. Shoot. Negative. Don't move. User guide. The person who guides us. Remove the packaging, open the blue box and connect the two right wires. Do not dispose of battery in the trash. That means here how we give an instruction and how we give a command. So instruction can be politely and straightforward and with a positive. So we can give a command with a positive way as well as negative way. School. Now wash your hands. This is a command. This is instruction. Negative. Don't forget your homework. That is a command. Airplane. Please remain seated until the seatbelt sign is off. That is the instruction when we sit at the airplane. Don't smoke in the toilets. That is the command. So these are the example where imperative sentence is used as in form of command or instructions. Let us see imperative with subject. Normally, when we use imperative, there is no subject because the subject is obvious. It's you. Sometimes, however, to make the subject clear, we do use a subject. For an example, everybody look, that means you are saying something to everyone. Nobody move. For an example, there is a robbery in the shop. Nobody moves. Wherever you are, sit down there. Somebody answer the phone. If you are busy in something, your phone is ringing, you are telling to someone, somebody answer my phone. You keep out of this. That means you are telling someone to keep out of this. We can also use as a subject to imply anger as in, you watch your mouth, young man, you be quiet, don't you talk to me like that. So these are the imperative with subject imply at the time of anger as well as you can make a subject clear. Now next we see unreal commands. What are the unreal commands? That means often express hope and make suggestion. But these are not a real command. For an example, have a good trip. Hope. Hope we have a good trip. Enjoy the meal. Hope you enjoy the meal. If there is no olive oil, try almond oil. That is your suggestion. Agar aapke paas olive oil nahi hai, to almond oil try kariye. शायद आपकी ट्रिप अच्छी रहे, शायद आपको खाना पसंद आए. तो दिस इज एन एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ होप, शायद हो सकता है. और यू कैन मेक अ सजेशन, अगर ये नहीं है ये चीज से काम चलाए. अगर आपके पास रबर बैंड नहीं है, यू कैन यूज अ थ्रेड. तो दिस इज व्हाट सजेशन. नाउ इंपेरेटिव डू, इफ वी पुट डू, अगर हम डू डालते हैं बिफोर द इंपेरेटिव, व्हाट इट्स इफेक्ट? वो रिक्वेस्ट होता है, अपोलॉजीज होता है, कंप्लेन्स होता है, या एम्पैथिक बट ऑल्सो मोर पोलाइट. फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल, डू टेक अ सीट. आप किसी को बोलते हैं प्लीज सिट डाउन, डू टेक अ सीट. किसी को बोलते हैं आप बैठने के लिए, डू फॉरगिव मी, आई डिड नॉट मीन टू ऑफेंड यू. अपोलॉजी, आप सॉरी बोलते हो कि मेरा ऐसा करने का मन नहीं था लेकिन वो हो गया. इट इज नॉट वॉज इंटेंशनली, अनइंटेंशनली हो गया. डू फॉरगिव मी. डू ट्राई टू कीप द नॉइज डाउन, जेंटलमैन. कंप्लेन, आप सपोज ट्रैवलिंग कर रहे हो, ट्रेन में जा रहे हो, रात को शोर हो रहा है, आप क्या करते हो? कंप्लेन करते हो. डू ट्राई टू कीप द नॉइज डाउन, जेंटलमैन. अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ डू विद द इंपेरेटिव इफेक्ट? इट मेक अ रिक्वेस्ट, इट कैन बी अपोलोजाइज, इट कैन बी कंप्लेन और मेनी मोर. इंपेरेटिव विद एंड एंड क्वेश्चन टाइम, लेट अस सी. इंपेरेटिव प्लस एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ एंड इफ क्लॉज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, गो नाउ एंड आई विल नेवर स्पीक टू यू अगेन. इंस्टेड ऑफ गो एंड वी कैन पुट इफ यू गो नाउ आई विल नेवर स्पीक. सो हियर वी कैन यूज एंड वी कैन यूज इफ क्लॉज. सेम विद दैट क्वेश्चन टैग, समटाइम यूज दिस क्वेश्चन टैग आफ्टर इम्पेयर. कैन यू, कांट यू, कुड यू, विल यू, वोंट यू, वुड यू. लुक एट दिस एग्जाम्पल, लेंड मी अ डॉलर, कैन यू? Help him with this, will you? Keep still, won't you? This is a question tag where you can use with the imperative form. So here we completed imperative sentences. From this we get to know what is meant by imperative sentences. Imperative sentences is to give order, instruction, command, advice, request. And here are the various effects of imperative sentences while using do and if and question tag. So moving further, we'll get to know what is causative verb. Causative verb is they cause something else to happen. Here are some causative verbs: let, make, have, get and help. Let's start with first causative verb, that is let. Let means permit, permission dena. What is the meaning or use of let? This means to allow someone to do something. For an example, I don't let my kids watch violent movie. मैं बच्चों को परमिशन नहीं देती. I am not permitting them to watch violent movie. Next, Mary's father won't let her adopt a puppy because he is allergic to dog. Mary's father is not giving permission to her to adopt a puppy because he is allergic to dogs. So here, let plus person or thing, whether it be human being or thing, plus verb and it will be a base form. This is known as let. Causative verb comes to make. Make means force or require. Zabardasti se karna ya aapko zarurat hai. What is the meaning of make? That means to force someone to do something. Kisi ko zabardasti se kuch kaam kara ke lena. So make plus person or thing plus verb, it will be a base form. My teacher made me apologize for what I said. मैंने कुछ ऐसे बोला तो टीचर ने मुझे जबरदस्ती सॉरी बोलने के लिए बोला. She made her children do their homework. What she did? She made. For an example, mother forced her children to do their homework. This is a make. Forcefully काम करा के लेना. Next, have. What is the use of have or meaning of have? To give someone the responsibility to do something. किसी को responsible करना और कुछ काम करने के लिए उसको responsibility देना. For an example, I had the mechanic check my brakes. I am going to have my haircut tomorrow. So had and have is what? My causative verb. Same as per in make. Made is what? My causative verb. I had the mechanic who checked my brakes. I have checked my brakes from a mechanic. Again, the next causative verb is get. What is meant by get? To convince to do something. किसी को convince करना कुछ काम करने के लिए. For an example, How can parents get their own children to read more? The government TV commercial are trying to get people to stop smoking. They are convincing the people. Government people are convincing ki smoke mat karo. It is injurious to your health. Next and the last causative verb is help. Help means someone in doing something. You are helping somebody. He helped me carry the boxes. Reading before bed helps me relax. Something is helping me. Someone or something is helping myself. That is known as help. So these were the causative verb which can be used for someone to do something, to convince something, to force something, or for some or for my or yourself. This is known as causative verb. So here we end up with our lesson number 27, imperative sentences and causative verb. I hope you have might clear what is imperative sentences and causative verb. After that, there is a test link and assignment link. As soon as you completed each and every slide, I request you to go to the assignment, complete your assignment, and then jump to your test. Complete your test and see how much knowledge you have gained from this Spoken English Certificate program. All the very best. Thank you.